The people wishing to speak on the vehicles for hire ordinance, you don't have to sign in. You can just approach the podium when it's time for you to come up and choose five people. Ready? Okay. I'd like to call the meeting to order. Councilman Reno, would you lead us in a prayer?
Do any of the council members have any special intentions? Let us bow our heads and remember that we are in the presence of the Lord. O God, we pause for a moment now to remember there is a very important person in the room today. It is you, O God. We choose to acknowledge your presence and say, as our national motto states, "In God we trust." We thank you for our community, a place where flags wave, where children are treasured, where teachers, law enforcement, firefighters, and our first responders sacrificially serve, where citizens truly care and people do heroic acts, great and small. We know that there are areas of our city and our country that need improvement, so we pray for wisdom. Many issues are complicated. We pray for wisdom to know what to do. Courage. Fear pulls apart. Give us courage to work together. Unity. President Lincoln said, "A house divided cannot stand." Help us to come together. Not that we all think alike, but that we all look for common ground. Civility. We all know it is easy to demonize, stereotype, and rage. It is harder to listen well, speak constructively, believe the best where possible, and work toward common ground and real solutions. Help us, Lord. Lastly, we pray for our elected officials, their families and staff, for all of our citizens, those in the front row, those in the back row, and every row in between. Would you bless each of them and keep them? Cause your face to shine upon them. Be gracious to them and give them your peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Councilman Impostato, would you lead us in the pledge?
Pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
In accordance with, Mr. Chairman, you have a quorum this evening. In accordance with Council Resolution Number B14550, please be advised that all cellular telephones, pagers, beepers, and other devices of this nature must be deactivated or silenced throughout the council meeting. Under the consent agenda this evening, we have item one, approval of minutes, the regular council meeting of March 9, 2017. Item two is approval of alcoholic beverage permit applications. We have none. Item three is approval of bingo and public gathering applications. Item 3A is application number 2008-17, St. Jerome Church, to hold a public gathering on April 14, 2017, from 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. for the purpose of a procession at St. Jerome Church. Item 3B is application number 2010-17, the Semi-Tough Cycling Club, to hold a public gathering on April 23rd, 2017, from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. for the purpose of a bicycle race at the Esplanade Mall. Item 3C is application number 2011-17, Hammond Transportation, to hold a public gathering on July 22nd, 2017, from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. for the purpose of a family reunion at Veterans Park. Item 4 is correspondence reports from the mayor, CAO, or department heads. Item 4A, at the request of the administration, a report from Mayor Zahn.
I recognize Mayor Zahn.
Thank you, Council Chairman. At the last meeting, I reported that February sales tax numbers were up by 2.2% citywide, but we had not received the numbers from the mall, their statistics. We have since learned that the Esplanade Mall is up 5.9%. approximately 16,000 over last February from last year. Meanwhile, we continue to attract new businesses to Kenner. Thus far in 2017, we have collected $2.7 million in license fees and renewals. This is good news. This exceeds the amount collected for the entire prior fiscal year. We have issued 2,362 occupational license renewals and 486 new occupational licenses. That is good news for the city of Kenner. As you know, you see the malls shutting down and other places, our strip centers, other ones coming up, and we get asked this at numerous civic associations. Why are we building new places? Why are we allowing new places to be built while these other ones are shutting down? But when you look at these numbers, it's not quite as bad as what we thought it would be. So I'm excited to hear that. Which leads me to the next issue. Of course, this Saturday is our streets millage election, March 25th. It's just a reminder to the general public that we have to renew, that there's a renewal out there for existing millage for the repairs and maintenance of our Kenner streets, and that is on the ballot this Saturday, the 25th. Thank y'all.
That will conclude our consent agenda this evening, sir. Motion by Councilmember Wilmot, second by Councilmember DeFranchez on the consent agenda. Council members, please vote. Motion passes 7-0. Under the public appearance agenda tonight, we have item 9, public hearings for final passage. Item 9A is a public hearing regarding resolution number B-16768, a resolution calling a public hearing on March 16, 2017, to determine whether the structures located at 501 Salvador Road in Kenner, Louisiana, shall be abated by repair, rehabilitation, demolition, or removal.
Okay, motion by Councilman Carroll, seconded by Councilmember Wilmot to remove this item at the request of the Code Enforcement Department. I understand that that structure has been torn down by the owner. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Please vote. Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0 to remove. Item 9B is a public hearing regarding summary ordinance number 12,149, an ordinance repealing Chapter 16 entitled Vehicles for Hire of the Kenner Code of Ordinances and replacing it with Chapter 16 Vehicles for Hire as per the ordinance herein.
Okay, motion by Councilman Segura, seconded by Councilmember DeFrancis to open public hearing. Council members, please vote.
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0 to open your hearing.
Councilman Segura, you all have the floor.
Go ahead.
Thank you. As he said, we're now in a public hearing, and this is where we will offer anybody up to five on each pros and cons to come up and speak. But before we get into that, I want to just give a brief outline of what will happen with this legislation. After many, many, many months of work by this whole council, we have come up with an amended piece of legislation that, as soon as the public hearing is closed, we will move to amend and replace the original language that you have seen on this. But it is also something that has already been circulated to all of the stakeholders that have been part of this, the TNCs, taxis, City of New Orleans Aviation Board. So the document is not, they've already seen, but for the sake also of the general public who might not have seen it, once we put up that replacement, we will then move for a two-meeting deferral. And the reason for the two-meeting deferral is, like I said, to give the public that time to see what the amendments are, what the changes that have come from what has been posted right now. When we do that, we do expect to get more comments, more messages, more information. We've gotten plenty of them over the last several days, and all of us up here hear and have heard the comments that have been sent to us. So we know that there is some concerns that perhaps we need to take a little different look at. So over the next two meeting period timeline, we are very much open for any other additional comments, any other additional proposed change to come to us, and then we will certainly vet that through us. And then when we come back in two meetings, we will be prepared to make a vote on a document that we perhaps can all agree to at that time. So even though we want you to speak, if you want to speak tonight, I just want to let y'all know that this is the course of action that we will be taking. As soon as the public hearing is over, we will amend with a new document. We will put it up for a deferral for two meetings, and then that allows more of the public who's not aware of what's in that document to see it and have more time for input from everybody to allow us to make a more conscientious decision. So that's, thank you, and we'll proceed with the public hearing.
Anyone else wishing to speak? Okay. Would you state your name and address, please, for the record?
My name is Warren Ruther, and I live at 68 Lakewood Place in New Orleans, Louisiana. I'm here representing a company called Airport Shuttle. We've been at the airport now for 25 years with this contract, and all the people that work for us are employees. I have to applaud you for the approach that you've taken by giving us an opportunity to present who we are in a meeting that I think will make some sense. Instead of just having everything out in the open, everybody just howling and screaming. But I think this is the right approach, and I think it's great that you're doing this. The contract that we have is very unusual with the airport. It's a bid. It's a legal bid contract that we have with the airport that we have to bid every 5 years. Our rates are set. We cannot change the rates. We cannot adjust them. They all come under the Federal Aviation because of our contract with the airport. So I just want to say thank you and looking forward to the meetings.
Thank you, Mr. Ruther. Reuter. Okay. Mr. Morella, would you state your name and address?
Al Morella, 4260 East Loyola Drive, 5th District, 45 years. I've been involved in this situation, and I've been behind the taxi cab drivers since this whole beef started. Now, the whole purpose, the whole reason for the beef was because the rules and regulations were not applied equally across the board. Now, according to the article I read in the paper the other day, they want to impose these fees, but they don't want to impose them across the board. And I'm totally opposed. That's what the beef was from the very beginning. I'm totally opposed that anything that does not apply across the board to the entire industry. This is all one industry. This is the transportation network. It's all one industry. If it's not a level playing field, I'm against it. I don't care if it's not a level playing field for either side. That's what the beef was. That's what the beef continues to be with me. And unless you all are going to apply the rules equally across the board, I believe in fair competition. So unless you're prepared to put something on the table that across the board for everybody, I'll oppose it. I'll be opposed to it. Now, you talk about in the paper that this fee that y'all want to charge, but this amounts to me is a road use tax. That's what it amounts to me as. New Orleans tried this when Dutch Morial was the mayor, a road use tax. Then you're talking about you use this money to repair our roads in the city of Kenner because of the use of these vehicles. Well, what are we voting on Saturday for millage renewal? That's supposed to be for road repairs in the city of Kenner. What's going on, man? Y'all need to explain this here. And not only that, if this thing passes, if you impose these fees, I want to know what kind of accountability are we going to have as to where this money's going. We're talking about some serious money here. You're talking about $4 on top of another $4 or $5 in New Orleans. Anybody got any comments, any questions? Thank you.
How's it going? Dan Zimmerman, 570.
Oh, give me 1 second. Oh. Councilman Impastato, you got the floor. Wait 1 second.
Mr. Morella, I want to make history in the 3 years I've been on this council and tell you, I agree with a lot of what you said. And maybe in 3 years it'll happen again. I don't know. We'll see.
All right, would you state your full name and address for the record?
Daniel Zimmerman, 5701 Durbridge Drive, New Orleans, Louisiana. Back when I moved to Kenner around 2001, and I lived here for about 5-6 years, one of the reasons I moved here was because of public safety. This is first and foremost a public safety issue. I drive for rideshare companies, both Uber and Lyft. One of the comments that I receive, especially during the busiest times of the year, is that the decision that these companies are trying to make is not whether or not they're going to take an Uber or a Lyft or a taxi, or if they're going to do ride sharing or drive their own vehicle, because of problems they've had from getting back to where they are to areas that are outside of the city, especially Metairie, Kenner, et cetera. So when considering any legislation and any impositions that you're going to place on these rideshare companies that go above and beyond what the rideshare companies have agreed to in the other parishes and municipalities, I would strongly urge you take into consideration the fact that if it's too strict or too prohibitive and it causes these companies to have to leave the city of Kenner, that it's going to potentially make things a lot less safe. Because if people are going out drinking and they're going to say, well, I'm going to have to choose, I can't no longer choose ride sharing, so I'm going to drive, that makes things much less safe for the people. I do disagree with Al on one thing, is that state law specifically states when they empower municipalities, local governments, to actually write legislation on issues dealing with transportation, that that they can place any other requirement adopted to ensure safe and reliable passenger transportation service, even if it's anti-competitive in effect. So there's no requirement to have equal rules across the board. Now, anybody who knows me politically will probably might be surprised to hear this, but I mean, if I'm going to say that I think the $4 of a tax is far too much, it's probably too much. Finally, though, the one main thing I wanted to talk about, I read in the paper where Councilman Seguir had mentioned the fact that mentioned that he believed that, and I mean, you can correct me if I'm wrong in describing your position, that all transportation drivers in the state of Louisiana are required to have a Class D license. Is that what you said? Okay. Part C of the motor carrier law specifically exempts transportation network companies from having to have those vehicles that are driven as rideshare drivers and for transportation companies. They're specifically exempted from the rules that are set forth in parts A and B. That includes things on both sides of the aisle, be it like if a taxi cab can have an open container, we're not allowed to have open containers. It also specifically states that the drivers in transportation companies have to have a Class D license, a chauffeur's license, and we have to have for hire plates, or they have to have for hire plates. We again, because of Part C exempting us from that rule, say that we don't have to have for hire plates, and we don't have to have Class D licenses. And if you're making the argument that says that because you're reading this law in a certain way, that we have to have Class D, it then doesn't make sense that you're also not requiring for hire plates if you're taking that same approach. Furthermore, I would argue that if state law states that transportation network companies are specifically exempt from the requirements, that local municipalities can't come in and overrule that and say, no, you're not exempt. The ordinances that you can write, you obviously have the authority under RS 334792 to write additional ordinances that go on top of the state rules dealing with rideshare companies. But if a state law specifically exempts rideshare drivers from needing to have a chauffeur's license, you can't then come around and say, but you have to have one. State, local municipality ordinances cannot override state rules. They can add on top of them, but they can't override them. So I'd seriously suggest that you retake a look at that, and I would be happy to show you the legislation or the laws that I read dealing with this particular issue, and sit down and we can have a discussion over that. If you think that I'm wrong, I would love to sit down with you and have a discussion about that.
Okay. Mr. Zimmerman, you have 10 seconds left.
All right, thank you all very much, and I appreciate that you all giving an extra two meetings to everybody take a look at it, and I hope you all come to a right decision that keeps ride sharing in the city of Kenner.
Thank you, Mr. Zimmerman. Okay, Councilman Segura, you got the floor, and I'll take it after that.
Thank you for your comments, and yes, we welcome anybody, as I said earlier, to give us any new information. And I'm not saying that that's new, because we do have a legal staff that does a very fine job for us, and we'll have to decipher if that's really applicable in this case, because I don't necessarily believe that that's the opinion that we've gotten already. So, but we'll be happy, come see me, we'll be happy to look at those statutes and compare them to the ones that we've been looking at to get that provision in there. Thank you.
Just wanted to say thank you, Mr. Zimmerman, and I can assure you that myself and the rest of the councilmen are all business friendly. We want the drivers, the employers, and everyone to make a profit. So we're working on it as a compromise solution for all of us. Okay, next person.
Hello. Thank you. My name is John Repstock. Thank you for having me here today. I got treated today when I walked in. One of my first employees was here getting rewarded, Mike Nicole, so I get to thank him and congratulate him. Also, my father had a business here some time ago in the 70s and 80s, Repstock Drilling Company, right at 2601 Lexington Avenue. And I say that because I'm involved here, and I'm glad I'm involved here. While I was growing up, like I said, my father did business here. Back in February of last year, I lost my job in the oil fields when the oil rigs dried up and there was no more work to be had. I had weighed my options. I was looking into going on unemployment and selling my car at the age of 60 and finding new work. That option just didn't seem possible. Instead, I decided to keep my car and I signed up for Lyft. After going through a rigorous nationwide background check and submitting all my documentation, I was making money to support not only myself, but my family. And by the way, I raised a 3-year-old granddaughter, so I was very, very happy about that. So many people in our community have embraced ride sharing. People don't use it just on special occasions. They use it every day. Many people use it in the morning to commute to McDonald's. People in Kenner can easily get a ride to and from anywhere in the city now, and there are more options to do so. And I like being part of that option. Many people have decided to get rid of their cars altogether, which is greatly reducing traffic and pollution. This would not have been an option before ride sharing came to the area. Bottom line, this new technology is the way of the future. We need to embrace this opportunity and not overregulate these transportation options out of town. I urge you to vote against, and thank you for letting the customers be a part of this process with the two extra meetings. I think that's going to make a world of difference, because I interview my people all the time, ask them where they're going, why they choose rideshare, and I'm amazed about how happy they are to have us here. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your comments.
Council members, my name is Fritz Messmer, and I'd like to thank you for allowing me to speak here today in view of the fact that the ordinance in question is to be amended. My statement is going to be very brief. Growing up here, my father was a consul general from Switzerland to the United States, and when he retired, I became a dual citizen and was a licensed general contractor for 22 years. When Lyft started operating here, I was going to try it just a couple of times a week, and I was so impressed with the service and the feedback from the passengers that I gave up the stressful occupation of being a general contractor. The only other thing I'd like to say is that I believe it's a blessing and a valuable service for all of us in ride-sharing that get our sons and daughters home safely after partying on weekends at 3 o'clock in the morning. And I say that from personal experience because I lost a family member that was killed by a drunk driver. So again, this is edited and very short. And I appreciate that you let me speak here today. Thank you.
Thank you. Can you give us your full name and address again?
Oh, I'm sorry. Fritz Messmer, 76032 Highway 1081, Covington, Louisiana.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Next.
My name is Benjamin. It's right here.
Who's that one?
My name is Benjamin Barker. I live at 2810 Tupelo Street. I'd like to thank y'all for hearing me out today. I've been driving for Lyft for a little while. Like many of the other drivers, I lost my job recently, and I started doing Lyft as a source of income. I love my job. I love the customers I deal with on a daily basis, and I just love driving for Lyft. Two broad perspectives I want y'all to take into consideration when you're looking at this legislation is a lot of the citizens of Kenner now were displaced from New Orleans due to soaring rent prices. They use Lyft and Uber and other ride-sharing programs as a means to get to and from their jobs in an affordable way. If you put on this legislation, they'll be priced out of their jobs. They've already been priced out of where they originally lived because of rent. Now they're going to be priced out of their jobs because of their transportation to and from there. Also, another thing to look at is first impressions are everything. If a ride-sharing program or a cab is picking up somebody from the airport and the first thing they get hit with is an exorbitant fee from the airport to their hotel, are they likely to return here or tell their other people, hey, yeah, it's affordable to get to and from the airport? No, they're not likely to. So just two things to consider with all the other advantages of ride-sharing programs, like keeping drunk drivers off the road and allowing affordable transportation through the city for the tourists as well as the people that live here. Thank you for hearing me out.
Thank you, Mr. Barker, for your comments.
Good evening. Aaron Dirks, 1229 Annunciation Street, New Orleans, Louisiana. Thank you, council members, for your time and for many of your individual generous time to listen to the concerns of the car services and van services in the city and of Kenner and in New Orleans and the greater New Orleans area. We certainly applaud your efforts to date. It's been Herculean, and in my opinion, having followed this around the country as a for-hire operator in a regulated environment, this legislation is progressive and quite fair compared to many of the other legislations that I've seen in cities around the country. So thank you for that effort so far. The one major area that we ask desperately for you to change in your construct is there is no city in the United States of America that we have found that charges a per trip fee to pick up in their neighborhoods or anywhere that exists, just a per vehicle inspection fee to pay for the inspection overhead and the regulation, or a driver permit usually. The per trip methodology was instituted just recently because of TNCs that practically aren't able to submit their vehicles for inspection. They're just part-time drivers, as we've heard tonight, or their drivers are part-time, and so it's more difficult for them to go through that process. However, we do it regularly for the city of New Orleans, as y'all know, and so it would be logical that we would subject ourselves also to any additional safety regulations for the city of Kenner. Just ask that you remove any per trip fee. We can't absorb that as a business. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments.
Good evening. My name is Niran Gunasekara. I live in St. Rose, Louisiana, 253 Diane Drive. I'm also the vice president of ASME Local 234, which represents metropolitan taxi drivers. I'm here in support of this ordinance because I see there is some fairness, and we are only asking to be fair and level the playing field. I think this ordinance brings us, we don't get everything we are asking, but it's much closer to what we ask. And so I support this, and I just want to remind the public who are listening to me right now, I'm not against ride sharing. I'm for ride sharing. I love the free market economy. I like the competition, but the competition has to be fair. And if you practice unfair business practices, this is not fair for your competition. So I know Lyft is not operating at the airport. They don't even want to pay $4, okay? Uber is operating at the airport paying $4. But they are charging the New Orleans price when our taxi fares were 33. We are charging 36. And this ordinance brings a good point for us because it's going to level the playing field because you are asking ride sharing to charge the same fare, $36 plus more than two people, charge $15 each. I'm for that. And I am for public safety. I want to remind everybody, a couple of months ago, a Uber driver just got out of the penitentiary, and he served 3 years, and he's driving Uber. So your citizens in this city have to be careful who you ride with. I could tell you personally, I drive Uber and Lyft myself, okay? But I am properly vetted. My fingerprints are given, my background checks are clearly checked, okay? I carry commercial insurance, okay? So I just want this to be fair and square for everybody. So you have something in place here, the fare they are going to charge from the airport to downtown or any, to the city of Kenner or the unincorporated
Jefferson Parish. You have 10 seconds left. 10 seconds left.
Okay. I want to leave this with you guys. This is Lot C at the airport. After Uber came to Lot C, these are the potholes. I could leave it to you. You could watch, have it. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments. Okay, can you state your name and address for the record?
Yes, I can. My name is Addie Washington, and my address, which is a Kenner address, 3033 Ohio. That is the same address that I vote at, which is my father's resident. I came in here today on behalf of the package that y'all put together, and we are sort of pleased with the package deal. My thing is, I feel that chauffeur license, we have to have them. That old law that the guy read was an old law. You were right. That's not the new law. So the chauffeur's license would be required, a physical would be required, and also occupation license would be required. Even though if they're working here in Kenner, wherever they get it from, they should require one. We have to have that. If they get the $36, we don't have a problem with that. The insurance, it's a problem in a way and a problem not in a way. The main things are the occupation license, the physical, the chauffeur license, and, you know, et cetera. We also want with them, and we know that the deal that y'all have put together is a good deal. It's not what we really wanted, but it's close to what we asked for. So we are in agreement, long as it's across the board, that is what we are in agreement for. We want fairness, and we want it to be across the board, not one-sided. We want everything to be the same. And like I said, first the $36, we don't have a problem with that. We have a problem with only the things that I mentioned, the occupation license, the physical, and also the, even I said a background check, because what I pay for background check, I'm not talking about Kenner background check, because Kenner don't do a background check. I'm talking about a nationwide background check where they lay your fingerprints down and they know if you done committed a murder in North Carolina, anywhere else. This is what we are asking for. These things we could agree with, and we don't have a problem with it. And that's all we're asking for is fairness. And if we get fairness, we're in agreement. We have a problem with it. See you.
Thank you for your comments. Are you for or against the ordinance?
I'm for it.
Okay. Thank you. You can state your name and address.
Yes, I'm Leon Matthews. My address, 3400 Octavia Street, Uptown.
Okay.
And I'm in agreement with the package deal that y'all setting forward, because if I need these credentials to drive the taxi cab, and if the other company doing the same job I'm doing and they don't need it, I don't see no fairness in that, because they doing the same job I'm doing, transporting passengers here and from, to and from. And so the package deal that y'all came up with, I'm totally agreed with that package. Like some of my other people were saying, it's not exactly what we want, but it's something we could live with at this time. Yeah, so I'm just asking for fairness. It's not nothing against Uber, ain't nothing against Lyft. I'm concerned about me. And I don't believe, and I see that's not no fairness, but the package deal that y'all come up with, I'm in total agreement with that.
Okay. Well, thank you for your comments.
All right.
Okay. Hi, my name is Christina Young.
Are you for or against it?
I'm neither for or against, but I'm a driver of Lyft, and I just needed to say a few things to get off my chest, because I feel like Lyft has given me an opportunity to give back to my communities, which I love. Kenner, I was born in, well, not born, but I was raised in Kenner. I just recently moved to the city of New Orleans about 5 years ago, and it gives me the opportunity to give back to both cities, especially Kenner is where I did a lot of, I got a lot of traffic violations for drinking and speeding back in the day. And I really appreciate Lyft for offering me a job so that it allows me to give back to my community. And I am so compassionate about picking up people who are like over intoxicated and really need a Lyft. And I feel like, you know, everybody should just, you know, just be able to be treated fairly and everyone have a job to support their families. And that's what I'm here for. I'm not for or against any ordinance.
Okay, well, thank you for your comments.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Cut it off. Stop.
Hello, my name is Mamadou Diallo.
Excuse me. We've already had six people on one side, six people on the other side, plus this last lady in the middle.
Okay.
So we've had enough. We'll be glad to talk to you. Any council members will talk to you after the meeting.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yes.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much.
Okay. I will entertain a motion in a second to close your hearing.
Yes. Well, we'll let the last two people speak since you already stood up.
Just the last
two people. Anybody else will speak to after the meeting? Can the gentleman behind you go first, because he already gave us his name and address, and we'll let you go last. Would you state your name and address for the record again?
Mamadou Diallo, 12345 I-10 Service Road, New Orleans, Louisiana. And I moved here 5 years ago from Atlanta, Georgia, because the opportunity that New Orleans have, It changed my life, really. And you have to let the technology take over. It changed life, it saved life, it changed families, it changed me. You know, so don't put over-regulated, you know, ride sharing. Because once you are over-regulated things, jobs move away. So New Orleans is a very nice place, and nice people, great food, great opportunity for everybody. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your comment. All right. Ma'am, would you state your full name and address, please?
Smilja Sulejmanagić. I live in Merli, 645 80th Avenue. But I work for the Kenner. I'm a taxi cab driver for Kenner.
Okay.
And I moved here. I'm from ex-Yugoslavia, and I moved 20 years ago. And the first things what I had to learn here, of course, English, the rules for everything, for the kids, for the where you live, everything was the rules. I think you know better, because in ex-Yugoslavia we didn't have that. And I tried to learn on the right way, that I didn't want to have any trouble with anybody, the cops, anybody. What's happened now? There are no same rules for us and no same rules for the people who do other job. Everybody need job. I'm working all the time, and I still want to work. What's happened with the rules? My kids start to go to the college, they had to go the rules. When they find the job, it's the rules. They check everything. They check background. I think everybody need to know who I am. I'm sorry. Who I am and what kind of people I am. You know what I'm talking about. And I think they need to work. Everybody need to work. You need to work also. But it's all about the rules. And now what happened with the rules? No rules, no same rules. It's only what I have to say.
Okay.
What is different between me and them? I have my back background over there in Jefferson Parish. What about them? And I think everybody need to know. And my passenger is very happy with me. They can find, every time they can find who I am. What about them? I think they need to have the same everything what we have. Thank you very much.
Okay, well, thank you for your comments. Okay, I'd like to close the public hearing.
Yes, go ahead.
Councilman, would you vote?
Please stipulate your motion to close your hearing. Councilmember Segura, second by Councilmember DeFranchez.
Oh, gosh.
To close the hearing, council members, please vote. Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0 to close your hearing.
Okay. Motion by Councilman Segura and seconded by Councilmember DeFrancis to approve. Councilman, please vote.
Wait.
No, not yet. Yeah, Councilman Segura, you got the floor.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to introduce the amendment that I referred to earlier. It's the amendment and the rewrite of the Chapter 16 that the clerk has for the record.
Okay.
Yes, sir. We will entertain a motion at this time. Motion by Councilmember Segura, second by Councilmember DeFranchez to amend and replace this ordinance.
Council members, please vote.
No, any discussion on the amendment? Councilman Carroll, you want to talk on the amendment? No? Okay, so we're...
Councilman Impostato?
Would you like to speak on the amendment? You have the floor, sir.
I'd like a point of clarification, because I think the language of amendment and whatnot is being loosely used here. I'm not in favor of the amendments, so I don't want to vote for the amendments, but if the motion is to substitute... I understand we can't say substitute and amend. We have to say motion to substitute. So I don't want this to be dubbed as we're vote. I mean, I'm not speaking for my colleagues, but I don't want to. I'm happy to vote in favor of substituting. So therefore, this proposed amended version is what it will be on the floor for discussion. But I'm not vote. I just want a clarification to make sure we're not voting for the amendment to the legislation. Yeah.
Ms. Attorney Rapier would like to speak.
This motion at this point is only to substitute and amend what is there. This is not a vote on to approve and accept as final approval the amendments.
Okay, fair enough. Thanks.
Okay, Councilman Segura?
No. Anybody else on the substitution and replacing?
Okay, council members, would you please vote?
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0 to substitute the ordinance.
Okay. Oh, Councilman Segura, you'd like to speak on that?
right. You can recognize Councilman Carroll first.
Okay. I recognize Councilman Carroll.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Mr. President. And first, I'd like to thank all of the Uber drivers, Lyft drivers, taxi drivers, and this citizens who are concerned about the quality of life and the welfare in the city of Kenner. You are doing your job being here today, and we love that when people come in and to give us other opportunities to hear what you have to say. That being said, you know, I have received a number of phone calls from citizens like yourself based on comments that either they took from the news or the newspaper that implied we were against the Uber drivers or Lyft drivers or taxi cab. I just want to, for clarity, say that is not the case. We are not against anything. We understand as a progressive city, it's important to be able to have jobs for people like yourself. It is important to offer quality services to our citizens. So if we felt that way, we should not be here. We always have to be positive to make things better for our people. But I just wanted to say, we are not against that. But what we are concerned about are safety issues for people. We are concerned about the issues for the city of Kenner from an economic standpoint that we believe, that's why we deferred this for two meetings, so there can be conversations. I'm not sure if there was enough conversations because obviously words have gotten out that we were against this and we're not. But there has to be conversations by the people like yourself that live here and myself, and not just the company themselves, because the reality is they are going to come in and move on to another place. We have to live here and live with the rules and everything that happens. So for us just to agree to anything anybody said would not be fair to you, and we would not be doing our job. So I believe we will have more comments. We have deferred it for two meetings, and I believe there will be some understanding, some compromise that we will come to. And at the end of the day, fairness, safety, and from the economic position are the three things that are important to everyone in this room. And we look forward to having those conversations to ensure we have all of those things. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Welcome. Okay. Again, at this time, I would like to introduce a motion for a two-meeting deferral.
Okay. Motion by Councilman Segura and seconded by Councilmember DeFrancis to defer. Council members, please vote.
No. What's that? No? Two meetings, but I do want to say on the deferral, I'd like to make a comment.
Okay.
Again, as I mentioned earlier, all we're doing now is deferring this for two meetings to allow not only all the public, yourself, to re-see the new document that is what we're going to vote on at the meeting that it comes back up in two meetings. That's the first and most important thing. We wanted everybody to see that document. Now we're in a period of time that we want to hear input from whoever's interested. Contact us, give us your input, so that we can put that into the vetting of the comments so that we can make a decision in two meetings to vote on. So that's where we want to go. We've heard everybody's comments. We know we've got more probable work to do. So this time, you know, we're going to give us more time to work on it. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Councilman Impastato, you got the floor.
Yes, and I want to thank my colleagues for introducing this deferral. I think it's absolutely necessary. But with the caveat that I think by our rules, we cannot move to defer something more than two meetings at a time. And so I want to caution the public that personally I think with the challenges with the communications we've gotten back from across the region, I think 30 days, I just don't know how we're going to be able to get it done to address the substantive issues and substantive problems in it. So I have later on in the meeting a proposal that hopefully will address that, but I just would ask everyone to be, I'm definitely in favor of the deferral, but I'd ask for some openness because it's more than just letting people know and address the comments. I think we have to invoke more participation to make sure we do make the most cogent and informed decision possible But I certainly thank everyone for their willingness to move this on and think about this, take another stab at this. So thank you.
Thank you. Okay, Councilman Francis, you have the floor.
Thank you, Council President. And I will mention that I've already spoken to other council members and have indicated, and we do have the opportunity to do so. After the two-meeting deferral, if we still have not, if we do not have a document that works to make sure that all of the issues we that have been raised have been addressed, we do have that option at that meeting to defer again. And we've done it in the past. And I will tell you right now that if we have not come to a document that everyone feels comfortable in voting to and to voting for that document and moving forward, then I tell you that I am in favor definitely of deferring it a second time or as many times as we have to make sure we do what's right for the people of the city and for every and for all the stakeholders. And remember, it's also for the stakeholders. It's for everyone concerned. Thank you.
Council members, please vote.
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0 for a two-meeting deferral. Okay. Item 9C is a public hearing regarding summary ordinance number 12,166, an ordinance amending Chapter 16 of the Code of Ordinances, City of Kendall, Louisiana, to enact Article 4, Transportation Network Services, and providing for related matters.
Okay. Motion by Councilman Impostato and seconded by Councilman Klein. Councilman, yeah, 9C. Councilman Impostato, you got the floor. No, we already voted on the deferral. Okay.
I got it.
This. Okay, can he speak?
Yes, give me a.
Can we wait a minute because it's almost impossible to hear what's going on? Can we please wait a minute while the people
ready?
Yes, we're in a public hearing, though. We need to open the hearing, close the hearing, and then it would be on the floor for approval. So first we need to open. So your motion is Impostato, second by Klein, to open your public hearing.
Correct, on 9C.
Council members, please vote to open your hearing. Motion passes 7-0 to open your hearing.
Okay. Now.
You're now in a public hearing. If there's anyone in the audience wishing to address, please come forward now.
No one is coming forward.
No one is here to speak on the item, so we will motion by Impostato, second by Councilmember Klein, to close your public hearing. Council members, please vote. Motion passes 7-0 to close your hearing. Motion by Councilmember Impostato, second by Councilmember Klein, to approve.
Councilman Impostato wants.
Councilman, you want to allow someone else to open?
Okay, Councilman Segura, you got the floor.
Okay, but I'm going to move for an indefinite deferral, so you want to speak first? Okay.
Okay, Councilman Impostato, you have the floor.
Yeah, I knew a motion for indefinite deferral was coming. I would just suggest, since y'all know, moving for an indefinite deferral kills the ordinance. Then let's just vote on the ordinance. I mean, what we've proposed, what is proposed in this ordinance mirrors our regional partners, Gretna, Jefferson, Orleans, and is perfectly consistent with those jurisdictions from a number of different levels and was formulated, I wanna make sure it's understood, wasn't done in a vacuum for three months or more. Meetings were had with involving the Chamber of Commerce, Uber, Lyft, taxicab, airport, City of New Orleans. We had some of these meetings that were, and it wasn't just me, Councilman Segura was intimately involved in that at all steps, and we talked about it. If there is a movement to not approve something that is perfectly consistent with our regional partners, then let's just vote on that. And if y'all want to vote it down, vote it down. I may not understand the propriety of that. What I would ask for is, if nothing else, do a two-meeting deferral, just like you did the other one. And what I've proposed later on for the imposition impaneling of a committee that would formally inquire the input of all of those vested interests and everyone across the board, I think what you're going to find is, once that input is implored, that something that is consistent with our regional partners is what is palatable across the board. So if you're going to indefinitely defer it, you might as well, let's just vote on it now. Alternatively, what I would suggest or request is an amendment to the motion to defer to have it deferred for two meetings as well, just like the 9B. So that's my request.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's make sure we know what's on the floor.
I'd like to make a motion for an indefinite deferral.
Motion by Councilmember Segura, second by...
I guess, if you don't mind, Councilman Segura, I'd like to move to amend the motion for deferral.
I don't know that you have to, because I hadn't got a second for it yet.
Two meetings, or
I think it was seconded.
Okay.
I heard him. I'm moving to amend the motion to defer, to amend it, to, instead of an indefinite deferral, to a two-meeting deferral.
Two meetings.
So,
okay, that's what's on the floor.
Is there a second?
Does Councilman Impastato have a second to his request to change the motion?
I'll second that.
Second.
Two-meeting deferral.
You're seconding a two-meeting deferral?
Yes.
Yeah, we're going to need...
I don't think you can amend a motion to defer indefinitely. You can remove the motion.
Yeah, I think
you can remove the motion.
Okay.
Councilman Segura can
you would have to
then I can
the
provide.
But...
Can I provide the verbal clarification that Councilman DeFranchez was asking for?
Motion.
Then I guess what I am asking for my colleagues is to vote against the motion for indefinite deferral.
Or you could do a substitute motion.
With the proviso that, pardon?
Or you could do a substitute motion.
Okay. Well.
But.
Then I move to substitute a motion for a two-meeting deferral in place of Councilman Segura's indefinite deferral, motion for indefinite deferral.
Your first motion would have to be voted on and either approved or declined, and then we will move to your motion. So we will send it to a vote for motion by Councilmember Segura, second by Councilmember DeFranchez for an indefinite deferral. Any further discussion on the indefinite deferral? Okay, I'm sorry. Councilman Reno seconded your motion for indefinite deferral. So we will now vote on indefinite deferral. Okay, everybody's good? Please vote on indefinite deferral. Your motion will pass 4-3. Councilmember Klein, Wilmont, and Impastato are opposed. Item 9D is a public hearing regarding summary ordinance number 12,174, an ordinance amending specific sections of Chapter 16 entitled Vehicles for Hire of the Kenner Code of Ordinances.
Okay. Motion by Councilman Impastato and seconded by Councilman Klein.
To open your hearing.
Hearing.
Yes, sir.
Public.
To open your hearing. One more. Motion passes 7-0 to open your hearing. We're now in a public hearing. If there's anyone in the audience wishing to address the council, please come forward.
No No one's approaching.
No one's approaching, so your motion is Councilmember
Impostato and seconded by Councilman Klein to close public hearing.
Thank you. Council members, please vote to close your hearing. Motion passes 7-0 to close your hearing. Okay. Motion by Councilmember Impostato, second by Councilmember Klein for approval.
Councilman Segura, you have the floor.
Thank you. I'd like to make a motion for an indefinite deferral.
Motion by Councilmember Segura, second by Councilmember Reno for an indefinite deferral. Council members, is there any discussion on the indefinite deferral? Hearing none, council members, please vote. Motion passes 6-1. Councilmember Impostato is opposed. Item 10 is opening of bids. We have none. Item 11 is reclassification of zoning for final passage. We have none. Item 12 is other ordinances for final passage. Item 12A is summary ordinance number 12,189, an ordinance amending ordinance number 11,061 to correct an account number for the fiscal year 2015 emergency solutions grant for the Department of Community Development.
Motion by Councilmember Carroll, seconded by Councilmember Wilmot.
Council members, please vote. Motion passes 7-0. Item 13 is resolutions and motions by council members. Item 13A is a resolution ratifying the appointment of Stephen M. Pettit, Jr. as an assistant city attorney for the city of Kenner.
Motion by Councilmember Segura, seconded by Councilmember Impostato. Any discussion?
Councilman Segura.
Thank you. Just brief. First off, wanted to point out that Mr. Pettit, based on his, I think it was last meeting, informed us about him being a very good reader. So in this position, he will be doing a lot of reading now. And so I want to congratulate him on being proficient to handle this new position as a good reader. So with that, I do wholeheartedly recommend the acceptance of appointing him an assistant city attorney, and that he be so allowed to do so. Thank you.
Okay. Seeing
Councilman Carroll, I believe.
Yeah.
You have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President. And also just to remind everybody that Mr. Pettit was a director of code prior to moving to the attorney's office. And, you know, I'd like to thank him during that tenure that he and I did not agree on everything, but it was always a discussion for us to be able to agree to disagree. So, and that's all a person ever asks. So I wish you luck in your new assignment and look forward to supporting if I can. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Okay, Mr. Mayor, would you like to say something?
Yeah, I appreciate y'all's support on this move. And just for some clarification, because Councilman Carroll just brought up a point, and Councilman DeFrancis had brought up some points in the agenda meeting. With this movement to Steve Pettit as the prosecutor, Mr. Rick Walter will become the co-director. Mr. George Bodie will become the assistant co-director. This is just like a chain reaction. Miss Mary Sharon Holland will take Mr. George Bodie's position as an assistant to the mayor, and that will leave a spot for Mr. Adam Campo to be our interim clerk of court. So all positions are still filled, but when Councilman DeFrancis brought this up before, and you were just bringing that good point up, it just clarifies it for the general public and also for all of you that I haven't had a chance to reach out to everyone. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to just say that I've been knowing Mr. Pettit for a number of years. I believe he's a hard worker. He worked hard in the code department. He did a great job in my district, as well as the other districts, and now I look forward to him being as the assistant city attorney and doing a further good job for the city of Kenner. Thank you, Mr. Pettit. Seeing no one else, would council members please vote?
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0. Item 13B is a resolution appointing Bianca Sadi to the City of Kenner Planning and Zoning Commission to fulfill the unexpired term of Raphael Sadi.
Tell him face to face. I'm putting it in writing. You might really believe it.
Seconded by Councilmember Wilmot. Councilmember DeFrancis, you have the floor.
Sorry. Thank you, Council President. Ms. Bianca Sadi, I believe, is in the audience, if she would mind coming to the podium. I just want to point out to you a little bit about Ms. Sadi. She has an LMSW degree in social work. She has tremendous experience in making unbiased, educated decisions on a daily basis in her professional capacity, and I included that in the document because I think that's absolutely vital. We need to have qualified people who can make those type of decisions on the Planning and Zoning Board. So I want to thank her personally for being willing to serve and help the people of Kenner move forward in the most progressive way. Ms. Sadi, is there anything you'd like to say? And we thank you for your willing to serve.
Of course, and thank you very much for the opportunity. I was born and raised in Kenner, Louisiana, and I work with Jeff Care Program of JPHSA as well as a licensed master social worker. So on a daily basis, we have to make unbiased decisions for individuals in our community and for individuals we serve. So I look forward to serving, and I will do the city proud.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, seeing no one else wishing to speak, council members, would you please vote?
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0. Item 13C is a resolution relative to the formation of a City of Kenner Transportation Advisory Committee to study the potential effects of the proposed transportation legislation on TNCs, taxis, and all other transportation in Kenner, including the airport, establishing the composition of the committee, providing for its functions and duties, and to provide for related matters.
Okay. Anyone wishing to speak? Councilman Impastato, you have the floor.
Would you,
Motion by me.
Motion by Councilmember Impastato, second by Klein.
Well, actually, it's motion by Councilmember DeFrancis and seconded by Councilmember.
No, it's not.
No. Oh, I'm sorry.
Impastato, seconded by Klein. Okay.
Councilman Impastato, you got the floor.
Yeah. As I said earlier, this is tied to most of what we've been discussing tonight. I do not believe that this was something that that I thought of within the last few days. Seeing the substantial outcry that we got tonight is just a snippet or an appetizer to what we've dealt with over the last several days when the actual amended version of that 9B was actually released to the public. And there are some substantial challenges that have to be addressed that I don't believe a deferral alone will accomplish. The formation of this committee, which interestingly enough is actually something that was done actually at Jefferson Parish prior to the adoption of their ordinance. By doing this, I think we put ourselves in a position to where we can gather not just community input, because the public input is certainly critical, as Councilman Segura stated earlier, and I agree wholeheartedly, but it's not just a matter of public awareness, it's actually a matter of performing an educated, informed analysis, gathering all the data and the potential impact that this legislation, and any legislation, whether it was the two ordinances I was proposing or the one Councilman Segura was proposing, it's really irrelevant. The question is, what impact would the adoption of any such transportation legislation have on the business community, the economic community, the traveling public, tourism, and all of those different factors? It's not that simple of an analysis. Having spent a substantial amount of time with the airport representatives, the City of New Orleans, GNO Inc., which has been awarded a number of times as the number one economic development organization in the country, the Jefferson Chamber of Commerce, the Jefferson Business Council, all of these different entities who have weighed in on these regulations in the past, I think we have an opportunity to get them all to the table, along with community input, along with the TNCs, along with the cab drivers and the unions, and we can put it all in an organized fashion, gather the data, and make a very cogent and informed recommendation back to this council. And I want to make something clear. I'm proposing that there be two on this committee. It be comprised of two district council members and one at-large member as representatives of the council. I am perfectly fine with me not being part of that committee. So I want to make that very clear. This isn't about Dominic being part of it, because I'll be honest, I've spent a lot of time with all of those entities and feel like I've been able to gather the data and gather the information necessary to make an informed decision on this. So I'm happy to defer that to my colleagues. So it's not about me being on it. But I think we then would have the representation from the council, representation from the Chamber of Commerce, from the mayor's office at the City of New Orleans, from the airport, the administration, the mayor here, and the Public Works Department, the Code Enforcement Department. Basically, when all of the issues that have arisen, we would have all of the people sitting at the table to have the discussion to make that analysis. I absolutely recognize and understand and respect the perspectives that particularly Councilman Reno, Councilman Segura have voiced both here and previously about the concerns we have to our roads and potential use of the airport. And the rest of the council understands that too. I recognize that. There's no question that's an issue we got to deal with. We've certainly got to deal with the additional use of the new airport. All issues that are absolutely to be concerned about. And not to mention overall city funding issues that we do have. The question becomes, is TNC regulation the solution to all of those issues? And that's where maybe I may have a disagreement, but I think that's where getting everyone to the table to actually connect the dots. All due respect to Mr. Nurhan, we saw a picture of a pothole. Do we honestly know that Uber caused that pothole? I don't know. I don't know that we know who caused it. I might have caused it when I was driving through there. But this is simply an effort to increase transparency, and candidly, the way all of this has been, we haven't had the gathered input from all sources to be able to make the right decision in the most informed way, because we can't ignore the effect that this could have. Look, if we run Uber, Lyft, TNCs, cabs, limos, we run any of those out of here or make the regulations overly burdensome on them, we could affect the utility of the airport. We don't know what goes in to our tourism industries, our Convention and Visitors Bureau, who I'm asking to be put on this committee as well. We don't really know firsthand what they go through when they travel across the country and try and convince people to come put their convention here, bring it to Kenner, bring it to New Orleans. We need those perspectives at the table. We need to understand what effect. We heard from some business owners tonight that this would destroy their businesses. We can't tread lightly on this. And for that reason, this 13-person committee that I would propose be given 60 days to come back with recommendations on legislation that would satisfy all of those concerns, I think is the most reasonable, fair way to establish equity, to encourage economic development, and to make sure we don't have undue burden and undue regulation. I would ask Mayor Zahn, is this a similar type approach? I know we didn't talk about it, but is this something similar that was done at the parish?
So my history with Uber and Lyft and taxi cabs goes back to 2016, when Councilwoman Lee Shang, who was a district councilman at the time, and I started trying to incorporate progress in business-friendly parish with Uber and Lyft. We know how that ended if you kept up with us in a 5-2 vote. Shortly after that, the cab industry came to us and said, hey, actually, in the city of Kenner, in your district, at Kenner City Park, most of you all were there, maybe not Councilman Wilmot at the time. You weren't on the council, that's why. But came there and complained, please, please put some regulations. Cynthia and I, at that time, said, we tried. What I'm concerned about here is, where are we going? Because when Councilman Jennifer Van Ranken came in, she saw that need again, which was just last year. And we did it again. But before we jumped into it, and look, I'm not coming back saying Jefferson Parish did it right and Kenner Council is doing it wrong. I'm not saying that. But before we did that, what we did was Jennifer called, Councilman Van Ranken, called many meetings with the chamber, at the chamber office, with all these players. Did we have a real committee? No, we had a committee that We just said, we opened the doors to everyone, let them come in. I know Councilman Segura, as the interim mayor, had a few meetings probably, or quite a few meetings in your conference room, but I think we need to have voices from the JCVB, the chamber, the JBC was involved with that. Not a formal committee. I think this is actually better because we have to project the image that we are equal to everyone and we are progressive and we are business friendly. I'm concerned where this goes, and I've expressed this as no surprise to any of you all. I've kept my thoughts out of it until today when I saw some meetings and agenda meetings where I thought it might be going the wrong way. And now that Councilman Impastato has asked me this question, it is our job to make sure as the administration that we're comfortable whatever you all pass. We have to be business friendly, we have to be progressive, we have to make sure we attract those conventions, those businesses that might not be using the city of Kenner. This is not a pro Uber or Lyft talk by me, this is a pro business in doing the right thing and keeping our taxi cabs where they need to be and actually an equal playing field for everyone. Yes, in answer to your question, we should have probably done it this way, and we didn't. We actually did pull it off, though. And I gotta say, I think the parish legislation ordinance is pretty good. I was one of those people with that. It was 7-0. It shows the community that we're trying to work with everyone. We need to do this here. This committee would be something that would help us with you all being involved in it. This came to you all last October, maybe September. I wasn't here. Mayor Segura at the time did a great job. We haven't been asked to be involved. I'm getting the calls from the chamber. I'm getting the calls from the taxi cabs. I'm starting to get the calls from the JBC. I'm getting the calls from the JCVB. Not too much from you all, but today I'm saying we need to be more involved. We need to help this as much as we can because the administration, whatever y'all pass, we're going to have to deal with. So the administration would like to have some input into this committee. The way you're doing it, Councilman Impastato, I applaud this. I think this is the right way to do it. We didn't do it quite this way formally, but this would be a little bit better, probably much better than what we did. But then what our end product was is we actually got everybody at the table. And we have taxi cab companies coming on tape at the parish council meeting saying they're happy with what we did. So when I see indefinite deferral on one of the pieces of legislation, I actually would have liked, and I passed this on to most of the council members, I would have liked to seen something interim because we're losing out right now, guys. We don't have anything coming in. I mean, if we get $4 off every ride, okay. If we can do that and keep Uber and Lyft, that's great. Right now, I ask everybody, what are we getting? Zero. I'll answer that. We could have gotten at least 50 cents before something was indefinitely deferred. Not criticizing anybody, but look at the business part of this and look at the part that we have. If we had done some, if you all had done something last October, God knows what that would have added up to over these last few months on an interim basis, not permanent, an interim basis. This committee, I think, would resolve some of those issues. I would support this. I'd be happy to put an appointment on there. I won't, like you, I won't obviously be on it, but we'll put somebody from the administration, these departments, and gladly bring some resolution for all of us so we can all work with a document like Councilman DeFrancis said, that we can all accept. I do support it.
And just my last remarks before I tend to the floor is I'd love nothing more than for all of those interests involved to come back and say that there's something better than what I was proposing. I'd love nothing more than that and would feel very comfortable with that because I would know at that point the analysis was done, the in-depth evaluation was done, so I'd feel very comfortable that it's not about my ordinance or somebody else's, not even close. There's no pride of authorship here, not at all. And so for those reasons, I'm asking for my colleagues to support this resolution and impanel that committee to do a 60-day, to come back to us in 60 days with a report of their recommendations.
Thank you, Councilman Impastato. Councilman Segura, you got the floor.
Thank you. In all due respect to Councilman Impastato, I heard a lot of what you said and makes sense at times, but this piece of legislation has been worked on, talked about with meetings, with a variety of the people that you all have or you have listed on your proposed appointees. And we have listened during these meetings to those, call them stakeholders. Ms. Michelle Hart's here. I'm sure she's going to have some terse words for us. She has her view. We have others that have very good views. You heard a lot of people tonight say that this package that we're going to vote on in a couple of weeks is looking very good. So I don't know that there's a need for a committee to restart and rebuild a piece of legislation that we've been working on for a year now that is almost finished. We're down to just a few issues, which obviously from the news media, it does appear that the dollars are more the bigger concern. And a lot of that is just having good, solid conversation with the parties where it's a negotiation and you got to offer and take. And in these months of discussions that we have been involved in, we've been open for discussion and take, but the discussion from the stakeholders has been more to resist what we have put out. So it's not for the lack of having their input, it's just they just don't agree with what we have. And I don't know that that's going to change if it continues for another 60 days. So I just don't really see the point of continuing this process that has been going on for a year now and is, for all intent purposes, perhaps only 30 days away from being finalized. And this is why we did ask, though, for this 30 days to get more input, so that if there's a point that we need to relook at, then we're doing that. We have offered that. But again, we have done this. This is not just new discussion. This has been discussion going on for a year now with, as Mayor Zahn said, with the administration when I was acting mayor, our city attorney. I mean, I won't even ask Ed how many rewrites he has done on this. Every time we would get input from one of the stakeholders and we would rewrite it to meet that input from them. So the document is in good shape right now as I see it, and it's just a question of we probably need to have a few words with some people to get to the dollar figure, where that should be coming from and how it should be coming. But I don't think that that's that far off. I think we have enough input just within the last 2 days, and if not just within the last day, from stakeholders who spoke tonight, given us a counterpoint on dollars, and those dollars are seeming to be acceptable. So a good part of the dollars have maybe been worked out. So we just have a little bit more to go on one aspect of the dollar. And the other restriction, I mean, the other regulations are regulations. I don't know what else to. We've listened to our code department, we've listened to our legal department, and we've listened to all of the stakeholders and made every attempt to put those words to meet those needs in there. So I just don't see where continuing through another, and I'm not sure you said 15 or 13 people being involved, is any different than what the seven of us have been doing. So again, I just cannot support this committee at this time. Thank you.
Okay, Councilman Carroll, you got the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President. And I'm just gonna come out front and just jump straight into this. I am 100 absolutely not support of a committee. Because if we want the committee views, no disrespect to Councilman Impastato or Mayor, I'll just pick up the Jefferson Parish legislation and read it. All of these individuals that have voiced their opinion, their ideas, is great. And we're not excluding them right now. But the people, the voters in the city of Kenner, they expect us to do this. We don't have to kick this down the can for someone else. It is our job to do this. So thanks for the chamber, thanks this, thank that. It is our responsibility to do this. If it, like Councilwoman DeFranchise says, if it doesn't happen in 2 weeks, we will do it again. Jefferson Parish took 2.5 years to get it done. Other places have taken longer. We're not on a timetable to get it done fast, but to get it done right. And just because another group decides to come in and they're going to give us their opinion, and my personal opinion is some of it is already out there. I know where they feel and how they feel about it. But we live in the city of Kenner. We are responsible. We push the button. The people who just left here agreed. They're happy that we've taken the time to do this. So now they expect us to do this. This is our job. So I totally disagree with that. I will not be supporting it. I have confidence in everyone that's up here. I even understand to get support from other people. But at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, it is our responsibility. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Okay. Thank you, Councilman Carroll. I'd like to just say briefly that we don't have a final solution now. We're working feverishly on a final solution. So we need a committee to just give us their opinion. We're not bound by their opinion. We all have our own opinions, but we haven't come to a final solution or final compromise. I think when this council took office, we wanted to compromise. We wanted to progress the city forward. I think we've done this. But we need to get a solution to this. A committee would be helpful in, as if it was one person up here, you might not think of everything. Seven people, you can think of almost everything. A committee might say, let's compromise this issue or that issue because it all concerns the fees charged. So I think we need to come to a final solution. A committee would help us do that, and I'm in favor of that. Thank you. Councilman Reno, you have the floor. Oh, Councilman Impostato, you got the floor?
No?
Councilman Reno? Okay.
Thank you, Mr. President. You know, I have to agree with Councilman Carroll. I mean, the buck stops here. If you look at other municipalities, it was Mayor Zahn just said when Jefferson Parish passed the legislation for this, they didn't have a committee. Gretna didn't have a committee. A committee like what's being proposed right now, okay? This is our responsibility. We've been working on it. I know that there are a couple of council members that don't agree, but there's more agreement with the here with the other council members than there are disagreement. So, and if you listen to the public, I mean the people, the parties that are involved, the cab industry, and even the TNC people that spoke tonight, I think we are at a better place now than we've been. So, I can't support a committee. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Councilman. Mayor Zahn, you have the floor.
Yeah, just a clarification. What I said was we didn't have a committee, but this is even better to have a committee. We had an informal meetings, a couple of informal meetings, maybe even three. This is one better step. So while you're right, I said we didn't have one, but I wish we had had one because mm-hmm. I think this would have made the process a lot easier. Just for clarification.
Okay. Thank you. Seeing no one else wishing to speak.
I want to close.
Councilman,
I want to close.
You can close.
I take issue with a bunch of the comments, and it's just hard for me to reconcile some of this because to suggest that all of the input from all the stakeholders has been already implored, and I'm going to accept Mr. Councilman Segura from that, because every meeting I had with all of the stakeholders, I could say Councilman Segura was there. So I certainly can't say that applies to him. But the draft of these amendments was kept completely from two council members here and the very stakeholders that it's being suggested were implored during this process. So to suggest that we've already done that analysis with all those stakeholders, I'm sorry, it's just not correct. And could I have, is there anyone from Uber here? Mr. Giuliani, could you please come forward? Give us your name and address, please.
My name is Nick Giuliano. I'm the public affairs manager for Uber. I live in Atlanta, Georgia.
Okay. What is your position, sir? I mean, who do you work for?
I'm the public affairs manager for Uber.
Okay. And you've been in that position for several months now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Back a few months ago, when the ordinances that we proposed back in December were deferred due to some proposed amendments. Since that time, what council members have you had an opportunity to speak with concerning those amendments?
With you, sir, and with Council President Klein.
Have you attempted to have that discussion with anyone else?
Yes, sir. Somebody working with us as well spoke with Councilmember Wilmot.
Have you had an opportunity to weigh in on the amendments that were put on the substitution tonight?
He's inferring that he tried to contact others of us and he did not return
that call. I just asked him a question.
We did not hear back from other members. That's correct.
Okay. I'm sorry. I have the floor, Councilman. I have the floor, Councilman. No, I have the floor. Okay. So that's all, Mr. Giuliano. That's okay. Are the issues, let me ask you this, are the issues with the proposed amendments, is it limited to just the fees being assessed?
The operational clauses of the version that was brought forward tonight are different than those that were discussed by the groups in months prior. They impose a regulatory regime that is very different than what other jurisdictions have adopted here in the state of Louisiana and different than what most jurisdictions in the United States have done. So they are different than what was agreed to by parties prior to this iteration.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
And my closing comment is, unfortunately, things changed when we started getting emails and calls saying that the proposed ordinance was a death sentence to various industries. That's a big deal. The death sentence, that doesn't tell me we're almost there. That doesn't tell me we're right there and we're good. That makes me want to say, even with the ordinances I propose, let's take another look at it. Let's get it right. When people from an industry are coming out in droves saying, what you're proposing will kill our businesses, and I'm talking about all of them, or run us out of town, services that our constituents want, I think we need to take a second look at it and be very careful. And we're not kicking the can down the road. I'm talking about having three council members on the committee to do the analysis. The reality is, and I could bring every one of the stakeholders involved and say, to suggest that they have had an opportunity to sit down and talk to a majority of the council members here thus far is simply not correct. So I hope and pray if you vote against this, I understand your reasoning, and I appreciate all of your concerns about getting this done quickly. I appreciate that. You know that. I'm certainly, I don't like deferrals. Y'all know that, okay? All I'm going to ask is all of those stakeholders, I'm going to take that as a commitment that all of them are going to be amply involved in this for the remainder of this. And if they're not, I think we're going down a very dangerous path that unfortunately we were on leading up to tonight. So thank all of you. You guys know I respect all of you and your effort. And I'd ask that y'all vote in favor of this. Thank you.
It's up to you.
Well, it's really up to you. I mean, you're the council chairman.
Your legislation,
well, then,
you
yeah.
have closed. Ms. Michelle Hart with the airport.
Is there any objection from the council?
And I mean, one more.
I did close technically. I don't want to abuse the.
Councilwoman DeFrancis wants to speak also.
Would you mind if we let her speak and you as well? And you as well? That's fine.
Thank you.
That's fine with me.
Michelle Allen Hart, General Counsel and Deputy Director of Legal Affairs for the New Orleans Aviation Board. Thank you for your time. We wholeheartedly support the idea of having a committee and having the same 60-day deadline that you guys had earlier voted to continue the legislation that was proposed. The draft legislation that was emailed out by the Assistant City Attorney on March 10th was completely different than prior discussions. There have been meetings for a long time, but not all stakeholders were involved. The airport was not involved until late last year. These things are important to our community. They impact our economy. There is data that is not before this committee because there are stakeholders who are directly impacted who have not, until recently, been notified of even the changes that were proposed on March 10th. That's why y'all are getting flooded with phone calls and visits and letters now, but you didn't have them before. That is because all of those businesses, all of those stakeholders, all of those job holders, all of these constituents in this area did not know about what was being proposed. And it's not just about the dollars. It's not just about the highest fees in the country that this city will be imposing. Not just about the companies who have come out clearly and said, we will go out of business. We are talking about the dollars that come in and the responsibilities we all have as government to do the right thing at the right time for the right reasons. And all the data is not before you. That's why you're getting flooded with calls. That's why you're seeing all this sudden interest, because not everybody was in the loop. And I know that because I sat in some of those meetings and I sat in later meetings where people came in and said, hey, why wasn't I in the earlier meetings? I wasn't invited. That's because people care and it impacts everybody. 60 days for a committee that actually gets input with a representative from the industries and the communities that are impacted who can provide you the data is gonna tell you what's really going on. There are also severe structural problems with how the statute is written now. There are problems that violate federal law, and I know that there is a difference of opinion, and those things should be discussed. But there has not been a discussion about those items. There has not been a discussion about these new $6, $4, and $10 fees. There has not been a discussion of any of it. And even when the stakeholders were asked for input and we gave the input, there was not the dialogue that you would have in a productive committee meeting where all those things are fleshed out in front of the public, like the public is used to seeing. The reason why you get all these calls is because everybody was blindsided. So with all due respect, this is something important to everybody, and instead of 60 days of deferral, where there isn't going to be open hearings and communications and sharing of data, let's have 60 days of hearings with three council members and the stakeholders where data is presented in a public way, where things are discussed in a public way, and that language is worked out in a public way instead of through separate and disparate meetings where not everybody's talking. Thank you for your time. I very much appreciate it. And we fully support, as the Aviation Board, the idea of having open discussions and committees in front of the public. Thank you.
Thank you.
Turn the display off and back on.
Councilman DeFrancis, you have the floor. Councilman DeFrancis.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Council President. I just wanted to make a couple quick points because I wasn't going to say too much at this point. I was very, very much in favor. In fact, I pushed to have the deferral tonight because I thought it was imperative that we have these discussions. From the beginning, as far as I'm concerned, there was never any effort to keep any information away from anyone, but it was a constantly dynamic, moving piece of legislation. I can't tell you how many times I received paperwork from Mr. Rapier, and there were constant changes. Ideas would come from each of the council people, and he would try to incorporate them into the piece of legislation. Then he would give us the legislation and say, is this what you meant to say? So it was constantly moving. It was a dynamic, not a static piece of document. And therefore, if it's in constant flux, it doesn't really make that much sense to give it out till there's something tangible that you're going to present to the stakeholders. And that happened very, very recently, just a few days ago. And when that happened, that should have gone out. And I believe it did. Am I right, Mr. Rapier, as soon as there was a final version?
Yes, ma'am.
It went out as soon as there was a final version. Once we realized how late that version was actually put in place, It was imperative that we have the deferral. There was never any thought, as far as I'm concerned, and I don't think for most of the council people, that there would be a vote taken tonight, because there wasn't enough time to really give the stakeholders the time to digest what was in that document and to come back to council members and talk about it and see if we can work together to find a final piece of legislation that everyone can accept. And that's what the whole point of this was, as far as I'm concerned. And again, I'm going to say I called Mr. Butterworth today, I called Mr. Heck today, I called Mr. Romick today, Mr. Dix. I can go down the list. And I told every one of them there wouldn't be a final vote today. I told every one of them, and many more people as well, that I won't even go into a name, the list would get too long, that there was going to be a deferral tonight so that we could have the time to work together to address some of the issues that have come to the forefront. So I just wanted to put that on the record. But I also made another statement to Mr. Butterworth, and I'm going to make it now. Mr. Councilman Carroll and I were on a committee working with the airport. During that, because of that committee, the buyout land was bundled and put in and sold and put back into commerce. Because of that committee, there was a smooth transition in the airport being moved to the north side. All of those things happened because there was communication between the city of Kenner and the airport. Once those things were done, what happened? Not one more meeting took place. Maybe some of these things could have been addressed and discussed long ago and gotten a lot more input if those committees had if those meetings had continued. And by the way, I mentioned that numerous times over the last 2 months. We're going to look into it. We're going to do it. Nothing materialized. So it isn't just this council saying, we're going to just, you know, take over. That was offered to the airport to resurrect those meetings so there could be better communication and open communication. That didn't happen. So I just want to put all that on the record. It takes both sides working together to make something happen, and I believe in that. And I pointed out to some of the good things that did occur when the two sides worked together, and I think everyone agrees that both of those two things I mentioned, and there were a lot of other positive things, but those are two big things that happened because of open communication between the city of Kenner, the city of New Orleans, and the airport itself. And I think that's important to put on the record. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman DeFrancis. Councilman Wilmot, you got the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President. I just wanted to chime in on this. This is very important. We need to get this thing right. And I believe that, and of course, I haven't been on a council real long, but I've had numerous meetings with various people, telephone calls. This is a big piece of legislation, and I really think we need to get it right. Again, you know, with the stakeholders, I've had numerous meetings. We've heard them here in the council chambers. I'm hearing everybody, and I want to make sure that we include everybody. So I'm going to be supporting the motion, and I think it's very important that we allow these folks to be able to chime in if need be. And in a 60-day period of time, I don't think it's unreasonable, and I think we need to do something to make sure everybody has a chance, make sure it's well vetted. So anyway, with that, I'll be supporting it. Thank you.
Councilman DeFrancis?
No, I'm finished.
Councilman Impostato?
I'm just very glad to hear that the last time a committee was impaneled with the airport that it was so successful. And this is an opportunity to mimic that and hopefully get the same positive results from such a committee collaborative effort as apparently was achieved last time.
Okay, motion by Councilman Impostato and seconded by Councilman Klein to close the hearing.
Well, no, it's just a motion to approve.
Legislation.
We motion to approve.
Here, and it's on approval. Yeah. What are we voting?
Yes, sir. You're voting on the legislation which creates the committee.
Right.
Okay.
Okay. Council members, please vote.
Mr. Chairman, motion fails 3-4. Council members DeFranchez, Reno, Segur, and Carroll are opposed. You got him? Item 14 is items removed from the consent agenda. We have none. Item 15 is acceptance of contracts and similar matters approved by the mayor. Item 15A, summary ordinance number 12,190, an ordinance accepting the lowest responsive bid received from Hahn Enterprises Incorporated to replace damaged pour-in-place rubber safety surfacing and to furnish and install new no-fault pour-in-place surfacing or equal at various locations on an as-needed basis in accordance with seal bid number 17-6376 and an amount not to exceed $50,000 annually for the Department of Parks and Recreation.
Motion by Councilmember Raynaud, seconded by Councilmember Carroll. Council members, please vote.
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0. Item 15B is summary ordinance number 12,191, an ordinance accepting the lowest responsive bid received from Golden Metals Incorporated in the amount of $8,981.40 for the purchase of materials for Mus Bertolino Gymnasium in accordance with telephone bid number T-17-2473 for the Department of Parks and Recreation.
Okay, motion by Councilmember Klein, seconded by Councilmember DeFrancis.
Do you want to speak, sir?
Yes. I want to let everybody know that we've done a lot of improvements at Bertolino Playground. We have the gym painted. We have new paint on the gym. We're getting the, some new letters on the gym. We have covers over the bleachers now, so when your children, your grandchildren play baseball or football or whatever, they'll be covered and they'll have fans to cool them off somewhat during the summer. We've also had improvements to the surfaces of the playgrounds. We ordered new portable pitching mounds. We've done a lot of improvements, and this $8,981 is to continue those improvements. So I would request that my fellow councilmen support me in this endeavor. Seeing no one else wishing to speak, council members, please vote.
Council members, please vote. Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0. Item 15C is summary ordinance number 12,192, an ordinance accepting the lowest responsive bid received from Gottfried Contracting LLC in the amount of $319,600 for the sewer lift station improvements at 35th Street and Ole Miss Drive in accordance with seal bid number 17-6373 for the Department of Public Works.
Motion by Councilmember Impastato, seconded by Councilmember Carroll. Councilman Impastato.
Thank you.
Have the floor.
Just real briefly, I appreciate all of my councilmen, fellow colleagues supporting this. This has been a longstanding problem in that Ole Miss area that predated my tenure here, and it's really been a terrible problem for that section of University City. So I appreciate everyone's support, wholehearted support, in helping that neighborhood with this effort. So thank you in advance.
Okay, seeing no one wishing to speak, council members, please vote.
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0. Item 15D is summary ordinance number 12,193, an ordinance authorizing the purchase and installation of an automated license plate recognition system software upgrade and licensing in the amount of $21,500 utilizing State of Louisiana contract number 44000047772 with LA Tech LLC for the Kenner Police Department.
Motion by Councilmember DeFrancis, seconded by Councilmember Segura. Seeing no one wishing to speak, council members, please vote.
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0. Item 15E is summary ordinance number 12,194, an ordinance accepting the lowest responsive bid received from Ashley Ross Construction, LLC, in the amount of $58,000 for new bulletproofing construction at the Kenner Police Complex in accordance with seal bid number 17-6374 for the Kenner Police Department.
Motion by Councilmember DeFrancis, seconded by Councilmember Segura. Seeing no one wishing to speak, council members, please vote.
Mr. Chairman, motion passes 7-0. Item 16 is ordinances and resolutions in summary for first reading. Item 16A is an ordinance levying the annual tax millage rates for the year 2017 totaling 17 and 17 hundredths mils on the dollar of the assessed valuation of all taxable property within the corporate limits of the City of Kenner, Louisiana on the 2017 tax roll. Item 16B is an ordinance declaring a 2002 Ford Crown Victoria VIN number 2FAFP71W22X137565 as surplus and authorizing its donation to the town of Clayton, Louisiana. Item 16C is an ordinance declaring a 2002 Ford Crown Victoria VIN number 2FAFP71W92X137532 as surplus and authorizing the donation of the vehicle to the town of Clayton, Louisiana. Item 16D is an ordinance declaring a 2002 Ford Crown Victoria VIN number 2FAFP71W02X137550 as surplus and authorizing the donation of the vehicle to the town of Clayton, Louisiana. Item 16E is an ordinance authorizing the utilization of state contract number 44000-10382 to purchase one Lason FI6670 flatbed scanner, including 1 year extended warranty from Lason Systems Incorporated, doing business as HOV Services, and the amount of $6,690.25 for the Kenner Police Department. Item 16F is an ordinance accepting the lowest responsive bid received from the Three Seas Property Incorporated to supply Batcher dirt and sand on an as-needed basis in accordance with seal bid number 17-6386 in an amount not to exceed $70,000 per year for the Department of Public Works. Item 16G is an ordinance accepting the lowest responsive bid received from Barrier Construction Company, LLC to supply asphaltic paving materials self-hauled and delivered on an as-needed basis in accordance with seal bid number 17-6383 in an amount not to exceed $200,000 per year for the Department of Public Works. Item 16H is an ordinance approving two cooperative endeavor agreements with Esplanade Realty LP related to the beautification and maintenance of the 32nd Street Esplanade Mall entrance corridor. Item 16I is an ordinance authorizing the purchase and installation of an on-base document management system software upgrade and licensing in the amount of $48,725.50 from Lason Systems Incorporated, doing business as HOV Services for the Kenner Police Department. Item 16J is an ordinance amending Article 8, Sections 10-170 through 10-181 of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Kenner, Louisiana, regulating sales from temporary stands or vehicles and house-to-house sales and solicitations. Item 17 is reports from the Council and our special committees.
We have none.
Councilman Reyno?
No. Councilman Reyno?
I have one, too.
You have one? Okay. Councilor Reynolds, you have
Thank you, Mr. President. I just want to remind everybody that tomorrow night starts the Treasure Chest Casino's first of three crawfish boils on the lake. Tomorrow night, they'll have live music by Groovy 7. Start time is 6:30. It ends at 9:30. A platter of crawfish with all the fixings is $10 if you're a Be Connected member. $15 for non-Be Connected members, and they'll have beverages for sale there. A portion of all the proceeds support local charities, and the following one will be on Friday, April 7th, and the band for that night will be the Wise Guys, and I'll announce at the next council meeting the last of the three. Thank you.
Councilman Carroll.
Councilman Carroll, you have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President, and I'll be sure, but I have an accolade to be able to give out that directly affects the entire city, particularly Theater 13, and that is, you know, congratulations to the Rivertown Theater for receiving a total of eight nominations for the Big Easy Theater Awards, including Best Musical for 1776, The Musical. So I think we owe them a round of applause for that. You know, as everybody knows, there are fantastic shows that go on there, and I think they're getting better and better each year, and we're bringing it more into the public, and even through the children and all being involved in it, who, you know, they're the lifeline of this to get an interest in this, and it will always get better. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Councilman DeFrancis, you have the floor.
Thank you, Council President. I received a flyer from the Kenner Fire Department. The Kenner Fire Department is doing a fundraiser on April the 7th from 11 a.m. until, they didn't give a final time. It's going to be held at 400 Veterans Boulevard, in Kenner, 400 Veterans Boulevard. It's a fundraiser for the 20-year-old son of one of the firemen who is having a lot of heart problems and major, major medical expenses because of those heart problems, and they're trying to raise money to help offset the cost. They're having a fish plate for $8. The gentleman in question has already had the surgery, and so therefore the cost, as I said, is quite prohibitive, and they're trying to help offset the money those parents need to put out and don't have the ability to do so. So thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. Councilman Segura, you have the floor.
Two, three. Hey, thank you. Thank you, Council President. Two things. First off, on Friday, April 7th, there's going to be a Easter egg extravaganza at Veterans Park. It's sponsored by Pamper Me Hair and Spa. It starts at 3 o'clock, ends at 6, and they will have two egg hunts and pictures with the bunny. Next is the announcement that next weekend is the Italian Heritage Festival in Rivertown. I want to thank certainly Councilman Carroll for his work in Rivertown, and then the mayor for the cleanup work that he's been doing in Rivertown, getting it ready for the festival. We look forward to that. The festival is always a big event down there. It'll be Friday night, Saturday, Sunday. We'll have the usual talent. We have Yat Pack. We have the Chiwis. We have Lena Prima, the daughter of Louis Prima, the Victory Bells, and the Bucktown All-Stars. They will be performing this weekend, so we urge you to come out. As well as the music, we will have our favorite Italian restaurants, Andrea's, La Bella's, Genusa's. We'll all be there serving their specialties, foods at the festival. So look forward to everybody coming out, and let's be Italian for a weekend.
Councilman Impastato.
I'd like to announce more fish fries. Apparently, we got fish fries all over Kenner inland. Divine Mercy tomorrow night has their weekly fish fry every Friday,
yes, every Friday
at the Divine Mercy Church parking lot. And also, I'd like to say to the Recreation Department and the rest of the administration, that Divine Mercy is very grateful for the continued help with barricades and other things that have been provided to help them with that event each week. So anyway, wanted to announce that. Also, wanted to finish with, I always tease Councilman Segura about this. You know, we announce events that we just know of that go on in our areas, but Councilman Segura was a bit humble. That's the Italian Heritage Festival is something that he has worked on and volunteers for years now and decades now. And so it's something he works very hard on. And I want to thank him on behalf of the actual Italians, of which he is not one. Okay. So on behalf of those of us who are, we thank you for your service, Councilman.
Thank you.
Item 18 is new business. We have none. Item 19 is unfinished business and/or motions to reconsider or remove from a tabled position. We have none. Item 20 is persons wishing to address the council on special subject matters.
Okay, Al Morella.
Al Morella, 4260 East Loyola Drive, 5th District, 45 years. First, I want to extend my prayers to the Anderson family, to officer in East Baton Rouge that was shot and killed answering the call. Secondly, I want to address the council as your employer, and you are my employees. The key to every successful operation is three C's: communication, cooperation, and commitment. Seems like the two biggest pieces of legislation this council is facing right now, we're lacking in that. And therefore, it's affecting the process, which I think is a little flawed. Now, first of all, to give you an example of what I'm talking about, we're going to thank Nicole's Limousine for all of his years of business in our city. And at the same time, that $4 fee, that proposed fees, is going to affect his business after we thanking him for doing business in our city all these years. The boat ordinance. You all voted on that ordinance, which was something entirely different than what the Planning and Zoning Commission submitted to you all. And Mr. Zembeck came down here and took this podium and stated that. That's not what was submitted. So once again, the process is flawed again. Now, you got the Pontchartrain Center, our facility, holding RV shows down there, holding boat shows down there, and promoting our city, trying to bring in revenues for the city of Kenner. And at the same time, y'all got an ordinance on the books, trying to put an ordinance on the books to make it difficult for people to own a boat, or own an RV, or own a trailer, after you got the Pontchartrain Center promoting this, okay? So it's flawed, and I can tell you something. You talking about a compromise, I'm gonna recommend this compromise. When you go back with this ordinance, when you start talking on it again, we got a debris and we got a junk ordinance on the books right now. Derelict cars, you can go in someone's driveway and tow the car out. So I suggest you amend the ordinance we have now to include derelict boats and junk boats. Don't penalize every boat owner in this city that wants to own a boat when they're not bothering anybody and they're not blocking anything. Anybody got any comments, any questions? Thank you.
After he sits. Now.
Okay.
Councilman
DeFrancis, you had.
Thank you. First of all, I think we need to clarify a couple of things that Mr. Morella brought out. So let me just start by saying there is a boat ordinance that is being proposed. I made a commitment, and Mr. Horner knows, I even mentioned it to him prior to the meeting, and the gentleman with the yellow shirt knows that I am not even going to put it on the agenda until I've had meetings with all of the people that are interested and have input on that particular boat ordinance. Councilman Impastato, I need to give him credit because he worked on it with me. The other councilmen have had input as well, so it's not just the two of us. We may have worked on the final product, but all the council people have been a part of it, and I want to thank all of them for their input. But there is something in place, and it will be done the right way, Mr. Morello, and that is to let them see it first before it goes on the agenda. So let's start with that. As far as the RV goes, I think we need to make a distinction, sir. There is a difference between the little trailer that people have and the big motorhomes. All along, not just recently, not with the new UDC, but way, way, as many years as I can remember, having lived in Kenner, that ordinance already existed. Anyone with a motorhome cannot park it in their driveway. It must go behind the front line of the house. And that goes back before when Mr. Shiro was here. So that was not changed. That was left alone. However, unfortunately for the boat owners, they're absolutely right. They were not ever required to do the same by the old ordinance. And that was an unfair way to just throw it out at them. So we're working with them to make sure we are fair towards them. And as you remember when you brought up Mr. Zembeck's name, way back then I was trying to work with them. It just never came to be to the forefront to go in the form of an ordinance. But we've been working on this long ago to try to make it fair for boat owners as well. And I just want you to know that it is not going forward till they have their input as well. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman. Okay, next person is Eddie Washington. Okay, next person is Niran, N-I-R-A-N.
I already spoke.
G-U-N-A-S-E.
He spoke. That was the gentleman.
He spoke already? Okay.
Yes.
Leon Matthews. John Rebstock. Fritz Metzer, I think he spoke too. Diane Swistard. Richard Brown. Mr. Brown, come on up.
Richard's still here. Richard Brown, 824 Sessions Lane, Kenner. And I'm also president of Citizens for a Better Kenner, and I'm speaking primarily as an individual, but partly on behalf of Citizens for a Better Kenner. First off, I'm glad, at least me personally, I'm glad that the council killed the latest manifestation of this ride-sharing ordinance. All I can say is I'm glad it was killed. I think these fees were outrageous. I'll get to that in a second. As to the proposal for the committee that Councilman Impostato had, I think that was a good idea. I'm sorry it was not adopted, but it was not, and that's that. Although you can still vote to create one at the next council meeting or any future meeting. However, since you did not create a committee, and you seven intend to work on this ordinance, I urge you to please have public meetings, work sessions, where the members of the public and the Uber and Lyft drivers and the taxi drivers, if they want to come, can all come. Now, I realize the taxi cabs fall under a different ordinance, but they want to have some say on this because they want Uber drivers to have to charge the same fees they charge. And that just ain't the way Uber works, and we know that. And if you try to do that, you're going to run them out of town. Two or three points that were on the amendment that you never got to that I understand would have been put into the ordinance that I want to address. The first one is the requirement of a chauffeur's license. I've known Dan Zimmerman, who spoke here earlier, for about 12 years. I don't think Dan Zimmerman and I have ever agreed on anything. But I agree with him that the way I read state law, you do not have to have a chauffeur's license to be an Uber or a Lyft driver. Now, someone made a comment that maybe it's been amended. I'll check again. If I was wrong, I'll be sure to let you know. No other city in Louisiana requires it. I'm not aware of any policeman ever having tried to write a ticket to an Uber driver for not having a commercial license. The last point is on the fees. The fees that were proposed to be charged with those amendments, $4, I think, per passenger for Uber drivers, $6 for limos, and $10 per passenger for the shuttle buses, those fees are outrageous. And the excuse I heard was that it's to pay for damage to the Kenner roads. Listen, folks, 90%, maybe more, but let's just say 90% of the taxi drivers, Uber drivers, and Lyft, and limos, and shuttle buses that pick up passengers at the airport don't set foot on 1 inch of a Kenner roadway unless Kenner owns and maintains the airport access road. And I don't think we do. But if Kenner does maintain it, then I'm mistaken on that point. All of these companies, but let's talk about Uber and Lyft, they go to the airport, they wait in the cell phone parking lot. To get there, they have to cross Airline Highway. That's not a city street, that's a state highway. To get into the airport to go pick up their passengers, all the roads to within the airport property to the terminal, to the departing ramp and the arrival ramp, all those are airport roads. Kenner doesn't maintain those roads. They pick up their passenger, they stay on the airport property, on airport roads till they get to the airport access road, they take it to I-10, and they get on I-10 to New Orleans. They never set foot on a Kenner road. Now, once in a while, they may take a passenger to the hotels on Airline Highway. Again, that's a state highway. Kenner doesn't maintain it. The state does. Same for Williams Boulevard. That's a state highway. Kenner doesn't maintain it. About the only hotels these drivers may go to would be the few that are on Veterans Boulevard. If an Uber driver just picks up once a week at the airport, and some pick up several times a day, but if they pick up once a week and pay $4, That's going to be about $200 a year they will pay for hardly ever touching a Kenner Road. Yet,
Brown, your 3 minutes is up.
Can I have about 15 more seconds, please?
Sure.
This proposed tax renewal that we're going to vote on for a $250,000 home, the average Kenner resident's going to pay $92 a year. For I think the average home value is probably more like $150. It's going to be, the average Kenner family pays about will pay about $50 per year for road maintenance. These Uber drivers who just pick up once a week are going to be paying $200 a year, and they don't even touch Kenner roads. Please, y'all have to fix this. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Mr. Raymond, R-A-M-E-N. Mr. Warren Rutherford, he spoke earlier too, and then Nick Giuliano, I think he spoke earlier. No one else has signed in.
Let her speak.
Ms. Washington, you want to speak now?
Yes, please.
Okay.
I want Addie Washington, 3033 Ohio, Kenner. I wanted to clarify something that he said about what we never hit, the Kenner streets. If it's a cab, if it's Uber, and they pick up, we goes to Chateau, Joyenne, West Esplanade, all of those streets are Kenner streets. If you come back here, 27th, 25th, we get people that goes these places. So quite naturally, we do use Kenner streets. We're not just using the service road and hitting the interstate and going on downtown. It doesn't work that way. It depends on where the passenger is going. And most of the time, that's why we have short drivers and we have long drivers. The long drivers is specifically to go downtown, and the short drivers are designed to go to the Hilton, the roundabout hotels, and all the resident areas that they have in the Kenner area. He didn't understand. He thought we just go one way. No, we don't. We do hit the ground with Kenner. So yes, we are riding on Kenner streets. And I just wanted to make that clear, because he didn't say it like that. He thought we were just going one way.
Thank you, Ms. Washington. See no one else listed on our list.
Wait. Gary Carroll wants to speak, please.
Councilman Carroll, you got the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President, and thank you, Ms. Washington, and Mr. Brown, thank you, and thank you for our conversation today that we had for a long, long time. But I just wanted to clarify one thing. You said that the Uber drivers park in that lot on by the airport. They don't park on the lot. The taxis park on the lot. The Uber drivers park on Warren Street, George Street, all of these Kenner streets. That's where they park, along with their trash. So are they having some burden upon our city? Yes, they are. So they park on all these streets before they get to go to, because when they get their call, then they come to the airport. They don't park on the lot with the taxis. The taxis park on the lot, not the Uber drivers. So I just wanted some clarity on that. And particularly in District 1 that I represent, I get calls all the times after I have some pictures that I want to be able to address with the airport, that is starting to make those streets between the airline and Kenner Avenue. And while I will be addressing the mayor, Zahn, it's a lot of trash all over the place. So, you know, particularly for District 1, we want that to be addressed also, since we're talking about everything. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Okay, Councilman Segura, you have the floor.
Thank you. I also want to just back up what Councilman Carroll just said, Richard, because I went out there this morning. I have pictures I'll be happy to show you. More than 50 cars were parked outside of the cell phone lot in and around our streets and our property for Uber, Lyft, whoever. They were there. I went and spoke with them, had a conversation with them in preparation of tonight, and asked them why they were parked there. Because we want to. So they do drive our streets. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman.
What happened, some illegal things was going on back there. I brought it to the attention of the airport. So what they done, the road, as you see in the paper that Mr. Leon give you, we began to get loopholes and all of this from the way they was coming in. So they chose to park on the street, the lot behind, the lot across the street, the lot over there, and Shell. So Shell said they could no longer park at their gas station. And that's how they started parking there, because they would have the lot all dirty. And the trash you see is right. They took that on their own. They were parking, and half of them still park at the airport. All that can't get at the airport because of the cabs goes on those lots. That's where they park at.
Thank you, Ms. Washington.
Motion to adjourn.
I'll second it.